Onivia, League of Legends highlights.
Issues, and this is basically KT having a different version of the same draft that Hanwha had last time, where they need to just go in all the time and get aggressive and be.
They have more damage though.
Early gank power here. No flash on Somdi.
Let's see whether Life can manage to land this one as the Winter's Wrath is beautiful. First blood goes to aiming. Flash is very comfortable there as, yeah, Vista. Can he clear the wave? There's another one coming. They're holding onto this as Life is just like, yeah, I'll get the tongue lash. Hold some aggro here for you guys as you lock this one down. It's a great play, but Life is still able to hold on, and that is two kills so early and two waves.
Like this I said, hey, follow-up gank. What a surprise. This time he doesn't have cleanse or flash.
But aiming has grabbed him once again as they do manage to take a lantern, but is it going to be enough? Permafrost is there. Hook is going to land, but it only brings Cuz closer. And aiming, yes, he's going to go down relatively low, but Somdi can do
very even. And first Turret Blood's actually a big deal here. Looks like Hanwha Life Esports are going to be the ones to be able to take it now.
And that actually does kind of swing things a little bit, as they will be able to get that little bit of extra gold for the situation. Of course, aiming didn't share any of it, so that is also big.
Tons of CS was lost for Hanwha Life Esports across the
board. You know? And that's precisely what Jovi managed to make happen, is on Fleek gonna look for a bit of a gank here towards the bottom side. There's the flash forward, the crush is brilliant, and the needlework not enough healing this time around as Dudu uses all of his health bar that they managed to hold on. This turret, and it runs out of minions though
from the Jinx. As Cuz just babysitting, as Vickler will take this top out of turret that he prepared earlier.
That is going to extend KT's gold lead. Just need to burst down this dragon.
Oh, they're trapped here, Karas.
Yeah, don't line up for Vickler's ult, who's going to miss, unfortunately, but Somdi is still very, very low. Cuz just going to deal with him himself, and now Rascal is popping up in the fight. The Azir goes down. Cuz is dealing with the Drake and may lose the battle as he doesn't have Smite available. Can't take another auto as Vista's going to have to flash to get out of the way of this support. He throws Life a lantern just to give him the opportunity. He's so large. Oh, the devour is going to be used on the Viego of all people.
And KT win everything. They even managed to get Soul Point.
Yep.
And the Baron has been started. On Fleek, remember, he's had some good smites so far today. See how this one's going to go. They're just not going to risk it. Karras is going to have to shift some sand to get himself out of here. That's a phenomenal ulti to come on through as Vickler does have to go back to his Unbound Soul. Then gets into a Gnarl, but you can see Hanwha. They're just too low. They can't fight this. Red White Guns are in there. And they do manage to secure it. On Fleek now running away with 110 health. And the Devour from Life for the extra movement speed gets over as well, as they're going to have to try and find him. And it's going to be Vickler that manages to secure it. There we go.
Well, that's the end of this story tonight. This is not going to be the game two power spike for Hanwha Life. It was in terms of the draft, but the game ended in the lane Atlas. And then we just saw KT with some really nice team fighting. And this time, once again, they focused on... Is it going to be Life POG, Aiming POG, or Cuz POG this game for KT?
I would 100% vote for Cuz.
I'm on the fence between Life and Cuz, because Life got that first flash away to set those.
Let's be honest, all right, Cuz looking for on Fleek. Can he find the Glacial Prison, though, is the question, as Rascal, in the meantime, is just destroying the enemy base. Same thing to be said for what Vickler is up to. And now the three are getting engaged on, but are they actually? As double teleports are coming through, that's a decent Glacial Prison to land on a lot of members, but now Vickler, he's found Dudu, who's hopping away. Emperor's Divide to deny, but it's just, there's an aiming there, and you don't really want to be there, Karras, and now he's going to get dashed on. Gnar is going to come through, and he does manage to get his way out. Aiming secures the kill onto Karras, but Dudu, he's limping. And Hanwha Life, they only lose their mid laner. I thought it was going to be worse. Super Mega Death Rocket to try and steal the Drake, but it doesn't work.
Nope. That's Infernal Soul to add insult to injury. And KT just going to push to end. They have all the tools they need. Except Crescendum, I guess, you know, could have been even worse for Hanwha Life, but like... This was a hand stiff game. I mean, the bottom 2v2 was played.
Oh, and a plan stiff. It's like
on the way out.
You can see KT are just very, very happy to shove all these waves in, take some control. Bot lane is going to push naturally as Vickler was burning. As on Fleek. Oh, decent hook is going to connect, but that is the least of their issues right now as Vickler diving forward, then running back out again. Rascal is just doing some stuff, not entirely sure what, as Dudu just dealing with super creeps. And this is what's happening, right? Like, KT just taking full control, taking health bars down as low as they would like to, and then destroying the Harmalife Esports base.
I mean, Rascal built his Onyas. I don't know if that was even required. I don't know if he was ever going to be in any danger at any point.
Well, Vickler's going to land yet another knock-up. A Glacial Prison once again going to go wide. That is maybe a vote less here for Cuz, but I'd still vote for him. As Hama are going to chase KT out of their absolutely obliterated base.
Because Han will have to expect they're kiting back towards Baron and might want to try to catch any stragglers, and then they just spring the trap. Not successful, but at the end of the day, with two waves of super minions coming through, and now a third one actually from top.
Oh, here we go, Jonas Strongshot. Cuz actually just walks out, tanks the rocket. He's like,
we just have some of these games where we watch 20 minutes of a team bleeding out. And this is one of those. We saw it last game too, and KT just outclassing. Yeah, last night as well. Like,
especially.
Just KT outclassing them in every way right now. And, you know, for Hanwha, it's just a rough ending.
It certainly is. This Nexus turret, not long for the world. Zonfleek was searching for something. Karas is going to find a two-man ulti as aiming's going to go down extraordinarily low, but he has a GE, managed to get his ult off as well. And as you can see, Harmalife Esports are just evaporating. My God, the damage here on KT. 9-0-5 for aiming. In the end, as the Nexus goes down and KT, they break the tie with Harmalife Esports. They were, in fact,